I got several comments from the users about the RDP wrapper not supported in Windows 10 or in my PC. So today we'll drive into it and check what issues I will face on a free updated Windows 10. Hello everyone, welcome to Installer Guru. For this demonstration purpose, we will use a fresh Windows 10 virtual computer for multiple RDP sessions. Please remember that RDP Wrapper is a free tool instead of using Microsoft's official RDPCL licenses. First, let's begin by setting a static IP for our remote desktop host, and for security reasons, we'll also change the default RDP port via the Windows registry. Next, we'll ensure our system is up to date by performing a Windows update to get the latest version. Now head over to the GitHub link provided in the description below to download the RDP Wrapper master file. After downloading, extract the files and run the installation by clicking on the install batch file. Remember to move the RDP Wrapper files to your Windows program files in the RDP Wrapper folder. If you run the RDP config check tool, you'll notice that it shows not supported. To rectify this, you'll need to edit the RDP Wrapper config files. You can find the config file links in the description below. Once you've made the necessary changes, the tool should indicate that it's now supported. Next, open Computer Management and create additional user accounts for RDP sessions. However, when you run the RDP check tool again, you might encounter an error stating that users are not permitted for the session. To allow users, you need to go to System Properties, Remote Settings, and add the users who will be using RDP sessions. After adding the users, check again and log in with the desired user account. If you encounter another error, don't worry. We'll address it by making important changes to the RDP connection protocol in Group Policy Settings. For demonstration purposes, I'll allow up to 5 users at a time, but you can configure this to allow more. To apply these changes, update your computer with the Group Policy Update command. The final crucial step is running an auto-update batch file from the RDP wrapper to get the latest version. After the update, make sure to modify the RDPWrap.ini file as instructed and restart your computer. Finally, we are able to log into multiple RDP sessions. That's all for now. Thank you for your time. If you found this video helpful, please consider giving it a like, sharing it, and subscribing to our channel.